In order to set ourselves up to do the verification validation, let's do the pre-analysis before we get into Fluent. And the first thing we will think about in the pre-analysis, what is a mathematical model we need to solve? And the mathematical model is differential equations with boundary conditions. You know, when I did my, a differential equations course as an undergrad, way back in the dark ages, I remember solving a simple differential equation along a line with boundary conditions at the edges of that line. And it took me a number of years to realize that when I'm using a CFD tool like Fluent, I'm solving a similar kind of a beast, differential equations with boundary conditions, except that the equations are much more complex. So it's useful to think about as, what we're doing here as a much more complicated version of something you might have seen in a differential equations course. Let me go to my slide, okay? And so pre-analysis forms the basis for verification validation. And if I go back to my pet framework here, the first thing I want to think about is what is the mathematical model, okay? So this is the first thing I want to think about. What are the physical principles and assumptions? Second, we'll think about how the tool is solving that mathematical model and what errors it's introducing in the process and how we can minimize those errors. And the third thing I'll indicate is what kind of hand calculations one can do of the expected results and trends so that we don't go into the tool blindly. Let me start with the mathematical model. It's a boundary value problem, and a boundary value problem, you might have come across this terminology before, is governing equations defined in a domain and boundary conditions defined at the edges of the domain. So you need three things to define a boundary value problem: governing equations, boundary conditions, and a domain. And these are the three things we would need to input into Fluent. And here I've shown it, schematically. In our case, the domain, as we will see shortly, is a rectangle, and so we have governing equations defined in that domain that we need to solve, and we have boundary conditions at the edges of the domain. And the governing equations are based on conservation of mass, momentum, and energy applied to a differential fluid blob. So a differential fluid blob is a vanishingly small fluid blob. And I talk more about, about this in my free simulations course at edx.org. And I'm trying to give you an intuitive idea of, where these governing equations come from. And that's under in the course, it's under big ideas in fluid dynamics. And the governing equations, as we'll see, are very complicated nonlinear differential equations. And thankfully, we now have tools that'll solve it for us. Otherwise, there's no way we could solve it. And the governing equations, it turns out, are even more complicated than usual because they have variable density. We'll account for variable density due to heating. And also the flow is turbulent. Okay. So what we'll do is we'll start by looking at the constant density equations and then see, okay, once we introduce the variable density, how those equations change, and then when we introduce turbulence, how those equations change. It turns out we can simplify the governing equations by making an axisymmetric assumption. So before I look at the governing equations, let's take a look at the axisymmetric assumption and what kind of simplification it affords. That's coming up next.